In this video tutorial, you will learn how to create PHP file upload script. So, stay with me. Hey, what's up guys? Senaid here from codingpassiveincome.com, the place where I help others to become a web developer much easier and faster than they will do it on their own. So, if that is something that interests you, consider subscribing. So now I'm here at my PHP store and I have created an M2 PHP file upload project, and also I have created a new M2 uploads folder and an M2 index.php file. So first thing that we need to do is we need to check, are we able to upload files to this server? So in my example, I will use my local host, which is XAMPP server, and I know that it's already allowed for me to upload, but for some of you it maybe it's not. So you will check it by opening PHP tags, and then here we will say echo and call the function PHP info, and let's open this in the browser. So as you can see, I have got some information about my server. As you can see, I'm using PHP version 7, and here you can see loaded configuration file, and the location of it is this one. So I will go to this location and open this file. You can go manually, but I will use my terminal and just like get it and hit enter, and this file is opened. So now I will search for file uploads, and as you can see, at the moment for me it is set to on. It could be set to off, or maybe it can be like this. So whatever the case might be for you, be sure that it looks the same as it is on my side. And after that, just save the file and you are set for this tutorial. Also, down below there are some other settings like maximum file size that you can upload, also temporary directory, etc. But the most important thing is this one here. Okay. So now, first I'm going to create an M2 HTML document. So I will just say HTML. In the head, I will just have title, and I will say PHP file upload. And here I will say body, and inside body I will just create a simple HTML form. So I will say form method, I will use post action, I will use this same index.php file, and since we are uploading file, we need to set encryption part to the multipart form data. Okay, and now we just need two inputs. One input, the type will be file. I will give it some name, let's say attachment. And we need one button, which is of course submit button. So that is all that we need. And now let's open this in the browser. So as you can see, we have choose file. We can click there, use any file, hit open, and then click on the upload. And as you can see right now, it is nothing happening because we do not have any PHP code that will handle the post from this form. So in the PHP, let us first, let's say this, and here I will say if is it post submit, which means if someone pressed this button, we will execute the part of the code that is here. So I will say first I want to declare where we are going to upload our files. So I can say target file equal, so the folder will be uploads. And now in this folder we need to set the file name how we will store it. So what I'm going to do, I will call the function base name, and I will get the name from the files array. So let me just show you what it is. So let's say I will just print these files. Okay, and let's see what we have, so that you know from where I have got this. Okay, so I'll continue. Choose file. Okay, and I hit upload. And as you can see now, this files is an array, associative array, and inside this array I have another array for the attachment. And as you can see, for this attachment we have name, which is this type of the file, we have temporary name, we have error, which means is everything okay, and then we also have the size of this file. So in order to get this name, I will say files attachment name. We can also test that, let's say like this, files attachment and then name, and let's see that. As you can see, we have got it. So basically what I'm trying to achieve right here is I want that my target file is in the folder uploads, and then the name will be whatever the name of the file is. But here I'm using the base name function because in some cases we can have some other characters that we don't want. So we just want to get the file name, and that's why this base name function is good. So if you want, we can echo this target file just to make sure it's looking good. And as you can see, our target file is upload and to this folder. Okay, so in order to upload this file to the uploads folder, we will need a function move uploaded file. So I will use files attachment, and then I will use this temporary name. So I want to upload from this location file to this location. So we'll use this temporary name. Okay. And we want to upload to the target file. And we can say echo file uploaded. So as you can see, I'm using here if statement, which means that this function move uploaded file will return true or false if the file is uploaded or not. And if it is, we will execute some part of the code. Let's say in this example we will execute echo file upload. Continue. It says file uploaded. And now we can go to our uploads folder. And as you can see, I have got my picture.png file. So what will happen if I try again? It will work again. But the question is, how can we check if the same file already exists and we do not want to override this file? So what we can do is we will check using the function if file exists. So I'll say if file exists, target file, I can say echo echo file already file with this name already exists, and let's say here else if. Okay, so let's test now. Continue. It says file with this name already exists, which means we are not going to upload this file again until we have different file. So we can go to the, for example, this, hit open, hit upload, and it says file uploaded. And now I have another file. The thing is now, how can we protect this form so that only one type of the files can be uploaded, so that you can upload any type of the file. So let's say you want to create an image uploading form and you want to allow only the image to be uploaded. So what we can do is, I can say here, I want to get the extension of the file. So I can say extension equal, and I will use path info function, and here I will just say target file, and let's say I will check for PHP . So let's see what is the extension. Echo extension. It says SQL. So the extension is this here, SQL. So we can say here, if extension different than PNG and extension different than JPEG echo only the image files are allowed, and let's say here else if. Okay, so let's test it now. I'll try to upload again, and says only the image files are allowed because the extension of our file is not any of the image that we defined. So if we try now to upload the picture and I hit upload, it says file uploaded because the extension is PNG. And the last thing that we can check is, we can find the size of the file that is uploading, and we can limit how big file it is possible to upload. So as you can see from this array, we have size, and as you can see here, this is 312 kilobytes because this is in the bytes. So what we can do is, let's say we will limit so that all files above 200 kilobytes are not possible to upload. So we can say if files attachment size bigger than 200 kilobytes, echo your file is too big. Else, okay, and let's test now. So if I try now to upload the same file again, I can go to the upload and says your file is too big. Okay, so let's, just for the purpose of this tutorial, I will set limit to the 500 kilobytes so that we can upload, and let's test again. Now it says file with this name already exists, which means that we passed this and the problem occurred right here. So what I can do is I will just go and delete the file and test again. Okay. And it says now file uploaded. And here we go. So we don't need this at the top anymore. It was just the purpose to show you how to do it. So guys, pretty much that's it. This is a really basic, and I hope that it's simpler for you to understand this. If you have any questions, please ask in the comments below and I will be happy to answer it. And also, if you like this tutorial, please like it and share it to your friends. Take care.